Hi everyone. Well, today this video is going to be just a little bit different. Usually it's us southern gardeners who have the advantage with our mild temperatures all year round, and you northern gardeners who struggle growing in the wintertime. But today we're talking about growing garlic. And in the north, you know that garlic loves the cold weather, but us southern gardeners in warm climates struggle growing garlic. So today we're going to talk about how to plant it, how to grow it, and include a few tips for you southern gardeners who want to grow nice, big garlic cloves over the winter time. First of all, just a few basics about garlic. It's a super, super easy crop to grow. It's perfect for beginning gardeners, or if you've been gardening for a while, it's perfect for you too. In fact, it's one of those plant it and forget it type of crops. Now, it loves the cool weather and really needs that cold winter dormancy period to grow nice, big bulbs. So in northern climates, you're gonna plant it a few weeks before your first frost date. But in southern climates, right now in November is a perfect time to plant it as the cooler weather's approaching. So today we're gonna talk about how to plant it and share some tips for southern gardeners along the way. First of all, what type of garlic do you plant? Well, in the past, I planted organic garlic I bought from Trader Joe's and haven't gotten very big cloves. You guys might have seen my garlic harvest last year, but I was still happy to get a harvest. But this year, I decided to try something different. I bought garlic that got really good reviews for growing well in warm climates. So first tip for you southern gardeners is pick a type that grows well in a warm climate. Now, the type that I bought, I got this from Baker Creek Seed. It's called Chamisol. So I'm pretty excited. I haven't even opened this bag yet to see what the garlic looks like, but it did get great reviews on their website for growing well in warm climates. And I think the person that I saw gave the review especially said it grows well in Las Vegas. So I figure it grows well there. It's super hot in Vegas. It's gonna grow well here in Southern California. So let's take a look at this. Wow, those are nice big garlic cloves, garlic bulbs, and it has a really cool purple color. Well, now that I have some garlic bulbs that are suited to a warm weather climate, what I did was I put my garlic bulbs in the refrigerator for about a month. Now, why am I doing that? Because garlic, again, needs a period of cold winter dormancy, and that tricks your garlic into thinking that's in a cold snap, like in the frigid north. Now, the second tip for you southern gardeners is to keep your soil as cool as possible. So I'm gonna plant my garlic bulbs and I'll share some more tips about keeping your soil cool as we plant it. Now, I like to plant my garlic in a container because garlic loves nice, loose soil. You can certainly do it in a raised bed if you want to, but you wanna make sure that your soil is nice and loose. And the container makes it just super, super easy to do. So we're gonna get this container ready. I'm gonna loosen up the soil, and you can see here I already have some other plants in here. I've got some basil, some peppers. I mean, look at this beautiful flaming flare pepper. It actually just fell off as I was getting this container ready. But we're gonna get the soil nice and loosened up here. And first of all, I'm actually gonna remove the drip irrigation. We'll put it back in later, but for now we're gonna remove it so we can prepare the soil. Now I'm just gonna loosen up my soil a little bit. I've had vegetables growing in here all summer long. You can see here's a little remainder of a zucchini stem. I grew some really nice zucchini in here over the summertime. And I'm gonna add some water in here so my soil is nice and moist for planting the garlic. I'm just working the water into the soil so the moisture gets all the way to the bottom of the container. And just continue that process until my container is thoroughly moistened. Now I'm just gonna be careful to avoid the plants that are already growing this container. And it's kind of cool, this container's doing double duty because these plants will die off probably as the weather gets colder over the next month. We'll make really good use of the space here because the garlic at that point will be starting to grow. Okay guys, so pop quiz, what do you think you do next? I'll give you three hints. Now, if you said we need to amend the soil, you are absolutely correct. I'm gonna refresh my potting mix with some brand new fresh potting mix. So we'll do that first. Just gonna add a few inches in here to the top and we'll work it into the soil. Look at that, isn't that beautiful? I always love seeing that fresh soil. So we are gonna work that baby in. I know that we are adding all these beautiful, fresh, organic nutrients to my soil here. And garlic is a root vegetable, so it needs these nutrients down deep in the roots to grow those nice big bulbs we all love. Now the second thing I'm going to do is add some organic fertilizer. So this is Trifecta Plus, it's my favorite. Use whatever organic fertilizer you happen to have on hand. And I'm gonna sprinkle in, oh, let's say about a half a cup for this 20 gallon container here. Just gonna sprinkle it in on the top. This is gonna look good. And next, my favorite, third favorite amendment, you guys might know this already, worm castings. These are Vermicera worm castings. Love these things. I have used these all over my garden and absolutely love what they do to my vegetables. So we'll throw about a half a cup in here. Look at that, nice and black. Ooh, the soil's gonna be nice. Let's do one more scoop, just for good measure. Look at the soil, isn't this beautiful? You know what, I am just gonna get my hands in here because I love getting my hands in the soil. Gonna mix it down in as best we can. And a little bonus tip here, guys. Adding some good organic nutrients are gonna help my basil plant and my pepper plant continue growing as long as possible. Maybe I'll even get a few more peppers off of it. This basil, oh, it smells so good. Isn't working in the garden so much fun? Okay, so we got our amendments in. I am gonna add a little bit more water just to moisten the soil up that much more. Getting a little dirty out here, but that's okay. Now that I have all my amendments in my soil, I'm gonna put my drip irrigation hose back in. And if you're growing in containers, I do recommend drip irrigation. It's just such an easy way to go. And for me, if I don't have irrigation in, my plants die. Now it's time to get our garlic plant, which is always exciting. Now remember, I talked about tip number one is keeping them in the refrigerator for 2 to 4 weeks. Tip number two is keeping your soil cooler. What you can do to help keep your soil cooler is to plant your garlic in an area where they're gonna get some afternoon shade, but some morning sun, because they definitely do need some sun. So let's get these babies in the container. Now look at this beautiful garlic bulb. What I'm gonna do is break this baby apart. We're gonna see all the individual cloves. We're gonna plant each individual clove. Wow, these are so pretty. This is my first time breaking open this garlic. Look at these beautiful purple cloves. Wow, I just can't wait to grow this garlic. It's gonna be so much fun. So when you plant garlic, you'll leave this little papery wrapper on, and we're gonna plant them about 2 inches apart and about 4 to 6 inches deep. So what I'm gonna do is grab my shovel here and make some little holes in my soil. And the reason why for southern gardeners you wanna plant them about 4 inches deep, because the farther down you go in the container, the cooler the soil is. And the cooler your garlic bulbs stay, the more they'll develop lots of leaves before the bulbs start to grow, which will help you get bigger bulbs. So I'm gonna break apart the rest of my garlic bulb here. Look at that, it has some nice roots on it. And we're gonna plant our garlic cloves the blunt side down and the pointed tip up. I'm gonna leave these papery skins on, and all we have to do, this is so easy, is just drop it into the hole. So the flat side is where the roots will grow out, the pointed tip is where the leaves will grow up through the soil. So now we're just gonna fill our holes in with soil. And in cold winter climates, your garlic will go dormant. You won't see growth over the winter time, but in warmer climates, these garlic shoots are gonna emerge within just a couple of days. And that's gonna be so much fun to see. And as far as how often to water during the winter time, you want the soil to be moist, but not waterlogged, because you don't want your garlic cloves to rot. So you really need to keep an eye on the weather. If you're getting a lot of rain, you probably won't have to water very often. But if you go through periods of dry weather, you want to come out, check your soil just by sticking your finger in, seeing how moist it is, and then watering if the soil feels dry. but deep watering will definitely encourage the roots to go down and grow bigger cloves. Okay, pop quiz number two. What am I going to do next? If you guessed mulch it, you are right. We are gonna prepare our garlic for its long winter's nap. And in colder climates, it needs a good heavy layer of mulch to protect it from the cold. But in the warm climates, it needs a nice few inches of mulch to protect it from the heat. So by applying a few inches of mulch on top of your soil, that will keep your soil cooler, encourage the leaf growth before the bulbs start to grow. So we've got our mulch applied, our garlic is ready for its nice long winter snap. Now we can pretty much plant it, which we've done, and forget about it. That's the wonderful thing about garlic. Now it does take garlic about 6 months to mature, and in the warm climates, like I mentioned earlier, you're gonna see those beautiful green garlic shoots emerge within a few days to a week or so, depending on the weather. So just to recap for you southern gardeners, growing garlic in a warm climate, remember to refrigerate those garlic bulbs so that it simulates the cold weather, and then plant your individual cloves 2 to 4 inches deep in an area where it's going to get some afternoon shade. Make sure you water deeply and apply a nice thick layer, about 2 to 4 inches, of mulch on top of your container or raised bed to keep your soil cooler. Leave a comment if you're a southern gardener and you'll be growing garlic in a warm climate this winter, or if you're a northern gardener, I'd love to hear your garlic growing advice as well. So make sure you subscribe because I will come back to do updates as my garlic grows. You don't want to miss that, and share it with a friend who might want to grow garlic as well. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.